specific finding the values of the constants here. Integral 6x cube 15x square minus 7x plus 6 by under root of 2x square minus 2x plus 1.
And the degree of the denominator does not matter.
Degree of the denominator should always be a quadratic in the root.
What if it's not quadratic?
Then this method will not work.
What if there's nothing?
Depends upon the problem.
Sir,
GDP
is
B0
plus
B1x plus B2x
square.
X square, right. You'll have to use a quadratic here. Differentiation of this will be this, correct? Differentiation of this will be b1 plus 2b2x into this, and then no, it's just one part of the quadratic. Kept this constant and differentiated this, now keep this constant and differentiate this. What are you calling as b1, b2?
You can see the same order.
Okay, b0, b1x, b2x,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And b3 is...
What are you getting?
B1 is... No.
B1 is 10.
10.
Minus alpha 2.
Yeah, b1 is 10, b2 is 1.
B2 is 1.
B1 is minus 7 by 2. B1 is 5 by 2.
Yes, sir. Do it slowly. I mean, if you are doing a mistake in comparing the coefficients of the powers of x, then that would be the silliest of errors to me. What are you calling B0? The constant of the quadratic?
No, not the other constant.
The constant of the quadratic, right?
B0
plus B1x plus B2x. The constant of the quadratic is 3.
Yeah, I got B1 plus 5. Oh, yeah, it's minus. Sir, is B0 3?
Yeah. Yeah.
B0 is 6.
B3 is 6.
B3 is?
Not 6. Definitely not 6.
Definitely not 6.
B3 is 10.
10. B3 is 10. Nothing is 10. According to RD.
We have RD.
This is RD. RDG.
That's
the.
That is objective mathematics.
Sir, is B3 14?
Sir, is B2 1? Is B2 1? Yeah, B2 is, yeah.
B3 is 1 now.
B2 is 1.
B2 is the term with the x square, no?
Yeah.
That is correct.
So B3 is 2.
What is
it?
B3
is 2.
Okay, then let me do this. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. So left side will become
second.
only two.
So six.
Okay. Multiply the board with under root of x square minus 2x plus 1. So you get
V3 is 4.
Yeah. What after 4 attempts you are getting here?
Oh my gosh.
Get a 4, you are taking 4 attempts.
Yeah, I have 4. Yes, plus V not is a
okay. Now let's start comparing the coefficient. Comparing the coefficient of x cube here.
Sir, what about
I'll have
differentiation of you get root 4x that differentiation that root part. That
yeah.
X square minus 2x.
So 4x minus 2 and 2
correct.
Below will get cancelled.
Sorry?
4x minus 2 and the 2 below 2 to 5 will get cancelled. Okay.
Where do we get 2 below?
Why you under root? Under root of something is 1 by 2. Okay. Now x cube will be 4b2 from here. And from here I'll get 2b2, right? Which means 6b2 is 6, so b2 is going to be 1. Does everybody got it? Yeah. Sorry? V3, why? I just multiplied with under root 2x square minus 2x plus 1. This 2 I cancel it out, so that's why I don't need to multiply it. Now comparing the coefficient of x square, I get 15 on the left hand side. On the right side I will get 2b1. This into this. And I will get minus 4b2. Any other term?
Plus 2.
From here I will get 2b1 again and I will get minus b2. Okay. Let's put the value of b2 as 1. So 20 is equal to 4b1. So are you getting b1 as 5?
Yeah.
Next. Comparing the coefficient of x term minus 7 on the left hand side. Right side I will get minus 2b1 plus 2b2 minus b1 plus 2b0. Correct? So minus 2b1, 2b2, 2b0, minus b1. Is that all? So let's put the value. So minus 3b1 plus 2b0 plus 2b2. 3b1 is minus 15. 2b0, not known. 2b2 will be 2. So b0 is 3. Are you getting 3?
Yeah,
it will be 3, sir.
Huh?
V3. Isn't that also a constant?
V3 is a constant.
Yeah.
Six is also but I never compared constant, I compared the coefficient of x now.
Correct. Yeah.
Now next is 6. The constant here is B1. The constant here will be minus B0 and V3. So B1 is already known to us as 5. B0 is known to us as 3. B3 is unknown. So B3 is going to be 4. So let's not delay and substitute it back. So B0 is going to be 3. B1 is going to be 5. B2 is going to be 1. B3 is going to be 4. And yes, I need to evaluate this integral. Okay.
Is it 4 ln?
Yeah. Take common.
Yeah.
Now x square minus x plus 1 can be computed into a perfect square as yes sir. So the answer for this would be?
Sir, is it necessary to take root to common outside of
the square? It's not necessary. But you have to divide your final answer with whatever you have getting in the square, coefficient of x. So this will be 2 root 2. The answer for this will be ln mod x minus half plus under root x square minus x plus half. So your final answer is going to be 3 plus 5x plus x square under root 2x square minus 2x plus 1.
So under root the initial function, sir, inside ln.
Huh?
Under root the initial function.
Under root the initial function, yes. That's what we learned in the standard integrals.
What is
this type? Type called Tx by under root.
There's no name.
You can give your name. Okay. I think last class we had taken integral of the form 1 by a plus b cos x whole square, right? And 1 by a plus b sin x whole square, and we could not take any problem on that. So we'll take some problems on that. What up? Any doubt anywhere, Pratik? So 4 by 2 root 2 is 2 root 2. I took the root 2 common. Okay, so we'll take up a problem. Integrate 16 plus 9 sin x the whole square.
What should we consider as
P? Cos x by 16 plus 9 sin x. What's going on in school? That we did in childhood days. Differentiate it very, very carefully. P would be cos x by 16 plus 9 sin x.
And we have to.
What happened, Nikhil? Dharul? Huh? Oh, okay. We'll discuss anyways also. So first start with the expression P, which is cos x by 16 plus 9 sin x. Find dp by dx. Please root in this section. Then, not always. When there is a sin x here, then cos x. If there is a cos x here, then you would take sin x. You did ask us. No. Absent. Oh, you went to the end. So, in this type of problem, the approach is we take an expression P, which is if this is sine, we'll take cos by this term itself without the square. If this is a cos, you would take sine divided by the term without the square. Then you do dp by dx. When you do dp by dx here, you would apply quotient rule. Okay, everybody will agree to this. This is the quotient rule. If you open the brackets, you'll get minus 16 sin x minus 9, correct?
Yeah. And it becomes minus 1 by 16 plus 9 sin x.
Then, just for the purpose of simplification, take y is equal to 16 plus 9 sin x.
Sir, you can cancel y and y square.
Huh?
You can cancel
Here itself you can make it, but just for the purpose of simplification, you can take this. No, 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 you cannot cancel. It is not nine sides. They look very similar.
Yeah.
I've seen cases where students take minus and cancel one. Very deceiving. Okay, so here sin x can be taken as y minus 16 by 9. Okay, so just put it into this expression. Just for the purpose of simplification, why does it help you to integrate it anyway? It's just helping you to simplify the expression. So minus 16 in place of sin x, you can write y minus 16 by 9 minus 9 by y square. Correct? So it will be minus 16 by 9 y 256 by 9 minus 9 by y square. So 256 minus 81, how much is it? 175. So minus 175 by 9 y square.
So
what can you do?
I've just expanded it properly. You can do it on your own end. I've just taken shortcuts. You open the numerator, divide it by the denominator, you'll get this thing. Just for the sake of simplification, I'll put the y back now. Correct? Is that fine, Nikhil?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, take this dx on the other side. Okay. And integrate. Please note that this integral, if I call it as I, then you have got I over here. If you see this term, this is actually your. So the answer will be integral of dt is going to be p. This integration, we already know how to do it. What was the approach here? Half angles in terms of tan. Correct? And this you would just keep it as 175 by 9 I, so that later on we can make I the subject of the formula. Right? So P is your cos x by 16 plus 9 sin x. Here can I take some shortcuts? Sec square x by 2 dx by 9 into 2 tan x by 2 plus 16 1 minus tan square, sorry, 1 plus tan square. Correct? How do I get this term? By writing sin x as 2 tan x by 2 by 1 plus tan square x by 2. So take sin x as 2 tan x by 2 by 1 plus tan square x by 2. So 1 plus tan square x by 2 will go on the numerator, which will become sec square x by 2. Is that clear? Now what is the next stage? Take tan x by 2 as
P.
Okay, so what will I get finally? Can I say I'll get 2 dt? Why? Because half sec square x by 2 dx is dt. So sec square x by 2 dx will be 2 dt, right? So on the numerator I will get 2 dt. Denominator I would get 16 t square plus 18 t plus 16. And 175 by 9 I. The factor of 2 can be anyway be cancelled, so it will be made 8, 9. Okay.
This is.
So that minus 16 by 9.
Now from here on, can you just integrate this term? In fact, I'll help you to complete the square. Yeah. So let's say I want to do the integral of dt by 8t square. So take 8 common out. So t square plus 9 by 8t plus 1, correct? Yes or no?
Yeah.
So it's 1 by 8 integral dt t plus 9 by 16, right?
So
1 by
8.
He's taken
8 common. I've taken 8 common. So t plus 9 by 16 whole square minus 81 by 256 plus 1. What is 256 minus 81?
175.
So can I say root 175 by 4 whole square? By 16 whole square.
Yeah.
So how is 1 by 8? So it will be 8 common out.
So it will be minus.
This is your answer. Okay. So your final answer over here.
Is it the integral of dx by what? X square plus a
square. Oh, it was not within the root. Sorry. Yeah. So it's going to be 1 by 8. 1 by a. 1 by a tan inverse x by. So x by will be 16t plus 9 by root 170. So this will go by a factor of. So, thank you, Shiram. So, we'll have 16 plus 9 sin x minus 16 by 9 times 2 by root 175 tan inverse 16 t. What is t here? Tan x by 2. Tan x by 2 plus 9 by under root 175. Plus 175 by 9i. So your I will be 9 by 175 times cos x plus 16 plus 9 sin x plus 32 by 9. This one will be your answer. Okay. So I know this is pretty long, but the approach is understood more or less.
Side